I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're here with Oregonian features writer Peter Carlin. Portland has what might be called a particularly intense streak of sort of high fidelity-esque music love and appreciation, a sort of obsessive attention to music. As a music lover and a consumer of music, what are the elements that give a town that feeling, that vibe, for lack of a better word?
Probably just a good subculture of younger, freaky people who hang out and live in cheap old houses and play their guitars all day long. I think that's got a lot to do with it. And Portland in the Pacific Northwest has always been a hotbed of music. Going back to, you know, the 30s and the 40s and the jazz scene up in Seattle, there was a big African-American community in the center of town. And, you know, and a lot of great musicians came out of where I grew up and where I went to high school. Ray Charles used to hang out there. He didn't go to Garfield High, where I went, but he hung out there. Quincy Jones went there. Jimi Hendrix went there. And, you know, and then walking on those same streets many years later, Stone Gossard and the guys from Pearl Jam. And, you know, it's for whatever reason. Maybe it rains a lot. You can't hang out outside, so you stay inside and play the guitar.
It was just, speaking of being inside, it was a few weeks ago that Portland, along with a lot of other cities, celebrated National Record Store Day, which is a celebration of mostly independent music retailers. What's your take on the future of the record store, maybe with Portland as a sort of a microcosm? Do you see a place for that going forward?
Well, I hope it lives, you know. I mean, in the same way that I hope, but I mean, on the other, I mean, I really do, because walking into a record store, I live really close to Music Millennium, and I walk inside there and wander around the stacks, and you can find, I mean, it's a way of interacting with art and culture that you don't get on the internet. On the one hand, the internet offers you the opportunity for a lot of immediacy and being able to stream stuff and hear stuff and interact with artists and art in that way. But on the other hand, at least the way that I grew up, there's something very vital and important about being able to walk into a store and just see stuff arrayed in front of you. And you can kind of, you know, you get cues from the way a record looks, and, you know, and you hear stuff being played over the sound system, and you know, you may be looking at Paul McCartney records, but then you look, you know, and suddenly you realize, like, oh, wow, who's, you know, Marshall Crenshaw, like, who's this guy? Or you'll hear something coming over. And so in the same way that I think reading a newspaper is a very old school and yet a very vital way of gleaning information, because you're not only reading the stuff, you know, even if you're focused on one article, there's stuff right next to it that you might not have thought you'd be interested, but something about the photo or something about the headline catches your eye, and you're being exposed to an entirely different kind of information.
You mentioned Seattle just a moment ago, and Portland, like a lot of cities, can sometimes be lost in the shadow of larger cities, either that are geographically close or that just have a very strong vibe of their own. Austin comes to mind immediately. From your perspective, again, as somebody who loves music and as a consumer of music, is Portland a town that supports the musical community the way that it ought to be supported? Is there a strong enough entrenchment of the music community in Portland?
I expect so. There's a lot of really successful bands who live here and do stuff. And I assume that, you know, but again, I may not be your best resource on that, because I don't spend tons of time hanging around in clubs and talking to musicians. I mean, to some extent I do that, but not as much as like Luciano Lopez, our just retired music critic. It seems to me that there's a lot of cool stuff going on. Mississippi Studios and Livewire on OPB, a lot of really neat venues for people to play music and to get exposed, you know, get exposure. And so, I feel like this is a really vital, interesting town.
When we come back, we'll actually talk a little bit more about the newspaper as a window into community and what that window might look out upon as times and eras and methods of information delivery are augmented and changed and transmogrified. That was a really, really long sentence that I will now end with this. You are watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV.